The sign over the toilet read, "Don't eat the big white mint." This place was a modern-day slaughterhouse filled with troublemakers, 40-year-old adolescents, felons, power drinkers, and trustees of modern chemistry. As the Tejano band played the San Antonio national anthem, "Hey baby, ¿qué pasó? I wanna be your only vato," some dude started revving his motorcycle, and Big Rob came in and said to the bartender, "I want a screwdriver, and you save the oranges for a sick person." Okay, never mind that. Never mind that today. We're actually going to look at Rob's deadlift training. Okay, so he's warming up here with squats, and more specifically, squats with a safety bar. And I should say this, he's training at the world-famous Big Tex gym. It's an awesome gym, and I'm actually going to be doing a seminar there with Johnny Jackson November 4th. It's one of the premier powerlifting gyms in the world, and I highly recommend hitting this place up if you're in Austin. It's in North Austin. If you were South Austin, it's still worth a drive. But anyways, more specifically, why the safety bar over any other type of bar? Because we're trying to get that squatting, which we're building that squatting motor pattern. However, we're not using a straight bar because it puts a little bit of strain on the shoulder. Big Rob's big guy with a lot of mass and all that stuff. So we're saving his shoulders with the safety bar. We've talked about this before. And these sets further are sort of like, they're almost like a warm-up too. We're not going to like a pre-exhaustion, pre-fatigue. They serve as an activation, and they actually build the squatting motor pattern there. And even though the weight's light, I mean, look how explosive Rob looks. It looks like he's going to do a dang plyometric. Gets tight and watch. Boom. I mean, look at that. His squat has looked amazing. Next video we'll do, we'll actually look at some of his squat training here. So he's getting the motor pattern down. After, you know, because he did a long cycle of Hatfields, as you guys saw before. And there was a bit of like a three-week phase there where the regular squats didn't kind of feel white. That transition phase. And we hadn't done the Hatfields in the off-season before, so that's important. I pick up on that so I can learn about that for future planning of all of Rob's trainings. Because some guys, like a Steve Johnson, the Forsaken Warrior, he immediately goes to Hatfields with a straight bar, and there's immediate transference. So it depends on the person, but you know, generally, even if you're not going to go like a one-to-one transference, say you can Hatfield squat, you know, 700, you do a straight bar with 600, say if you do something like that. If it's not that much of a straightforward transference, it generally should be able to get back to a regular squat bar very effectively in 3 weeks, 4 weeks tops. It took about, you know, 3 weeks of training, a week of deloading, and he's, you know, right on his money. I would say we wouldn't do this because the meet's not till November, but with a gun to his head, I would say Rob could for sure hit a squat PR as we speak. But, you know, we're not about trying to be gym heroes. Rob's going to save it on the platform, and I think that's why he's going to be, you know, possibly the best of all time, if certainly one of the best of all time, is because he gets that. He's not, you know, trying to develop some sort of gym folklore. He's saving it for when it counts on the platform. Because, you know, if Rob competes 3 times a year, it doesn't really matter as much how strong he is the other 362 days out of the year. So, I mean, obviously, he's going to be the way he trains, he's strong for anything he needs. But this is 740 pounds for 3 reps. It's a huge PR for Rob. It's a 20-pound PR, in fact. Watch him. Gets ready. You watch how he warms up every rep, every set. You know, he's looking the same. Boom. He's very dialed in on his deadlift. One, boom. Two, easy money. That's so easy. Got a little drag in the third one, but I definitely am positive. Having trained Rob for a while now, he for sure had 4 reps on any day of the week, and I'd say about a 90% chance of 5 reps right there. Okay, so on these reps, he really wants to work on dialing that form and working the compensatory acceleration as fast as he can, because we talked about before, every single rep, every single set, you get the most out of it because force is mass times acceleration. So you can't do a ton of sets at 90%+. But these lighter sets, you can pull them as hard as you would with that, and you don't get the same strain, but you get a lot of the same, you know, benefits. You get the, if you pull a lighter weight like this with maximum force, you get a lot of the maximal strength benefits as well as the explosive strength benefits. And when you're doing these compensatory acceleration training, I always say you want to do them as best you can by keeping, you want to keep your same form. So for instance, in if you're throwing a shot put, say you're throwing like a 16 pound shot put, you're going to train with a lighter shot put, you might be able to change your technique around to make that lighter shot put go farther. But it, you know, what's the transference you're after? Just where, like, if Rob started rolling the bar with 555 and got kind of loose and kind of tightened at the last second and jerked it up and it moved faster, but it's a totally different technique, you know, what good with that? So the compensatory acceleration is you're doing maximum force while maintaining tightness and technique, because if you sacrifice that, you sacrifice the benefits. So these are, here's one of my favorite shrug variations right here. I actually got this sucker from Paul Carter. He got damn good traps too. And what he's doing here is, it's a seated camber bar shrug. He's holding at the top, 3 second hold at the top. If you've never done these before, it's gonna light your traps up. And here we go into neutral grip pull-ups. Rob weighs 307 pounds, excuse me. And he's doing these with 110 pounds over body weight. Look at that, you know, like that back. I mean, if Rob decided to go on a leaning phase, he put it this way, it wouldn't be, you know, some podunk, you know, male stripping in the middle of some field in Navasota. This would be, you know, A-team at night, Chippendales male review. You know, not that we encourage that lifestyle, but if he wanted to go that way, he cut down, he'd have a lot of offers. Okay, pull-throughs here. Getting good, forceful hip extension. And these can bring you the power to lock out those deadlifts. Boom. Control, explode. Violent hip thrusts. Boom. Awesome. Look, so Rob's gonna, I mean, there's no tell, I hate to make a prediction on what he's gonna pull at this point, because I almost feel like I'm limiting him in that sense, because I mean, it could be as high as 900 pounds in November. I'm dead serious. Rob is not a gym lifter. Rob is, Rob's the kind of guy that's gonna show up when, you know, when it counts. Like I said, if your back's up against the wall, there's just nobody better. And you see big Robert Gallegos, he's one of the owners of Big Tex, walking around there. Suitcase deadlifts here. So I like to say these are sort of like a, you know, the Swiss Army knife of a lot of these movements here, because you're not gonna get, like, it's maybe not the best core exercise, it's maybe not the best grip exercise, but what it does is it kind of gives you, if you don't use straps here, like, yeah, he might be able to go a little bit heavier with no straps there and do a little bit more weight, so get a slightly better quote unquote core workout. But the flip side is, you know, he's not using that much less weight, if any, and now he's doing a grip workout too, so you can accomplish a lot of things with this movement. So that's why I say it's sort of like a Swiss Army knife type of movement, and without having to do so much, you know, direct grip training and whatnot. So this is again called the suitcase, and yes, it is much harder with a barbell than it would be with farmer's walk implements. Here we go, Rob. So, boom. This is very exciting times. And it's like, as old Blue Eyes Frank Sinatra said, the best is yet to come for Big Rob.